Good afternoon. And welcome as we gather to celebrate the introduction of this year's theme and also respect Life Sunday and month. We do this in the midst of Word and Eucharist. Our Mass this evening is being celebrated for Don Gillen, and tomorrow remember and pray for Martha Ann Mormon. Our sanctuary light will burn this week in honor of Father John Geis. He celebrates his 86th birthday this week, I believe. Our cookout is going to be a cook-in tonight after following Mass. The men will be grilling all the meat outside, but we will eat inside. So hopefully many of you can join us. Tara Vicky, a member of our faith formation team, will introduce our theme by sharing her thoughts of this year's theme with you.
We use this weekend to open our new theme for the upcoming liturgical year and bring attention to respecting one another and respecting life. Together in His love. A body does not function without the heart. A car cannot function without its wheels, and a church cannot function without its people. We are better together. Together in His love, we start with faith the size of a mustard seed and turn it into the size of courage that David had. We help each other through hard times and praise each other through the good ones. We bring generations together for a singular purpose, to spread the good news of Christ Jesus. We wash each other's feet so that we can walk in the footsteps of Christ. We sing together for the angels to hear, pray together so we can move mountains, and together in His love, we keep the Catholic faith strong. Together in this church, these pews, and this praying space is where we do some of our best work. Our best work is done together. Together in His love.
The red candles that will be carried up in our procession symbolizes all who have lost their lives through disrespect for life in all its forms. Please rise.
Please join us in singing number 582, Companions on the Journey.
the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with us always. Indeed, we are together always when we are in God's love, knowing that He is here with us, guiding us, loving us every day. As we open our prayer, let us keep in mind that He asks us to do the same for each other. Lord Jesus, You came to reveal the unending love of our Father for us all. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, help us to show forth this love for each other. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, fill us with Your life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of Your kindness surpass the merits and desires of all those who come to You, pour out Your mercy upon us, pardon what our conscience may dread, that we may give to You in our prayer all the love that You seek. For we ask this through our Lord Jesus, who lives one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and He brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all wild animals, but none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, He took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that He had taken from the man. When He brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh.
This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one flesh. The word of the Lord.
May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives. May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways, for you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall be you and favored.
May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives.
Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recesses of your home. Your children are like olive plants around your table.
May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord blesses you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. May you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel.
May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, he, for a little while, was made lower than the angels, that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. For it was fitting that he, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the leader to their salvation perfect through suffering. He who consecrates and those who are being consecrated all have one origin. Therefore, he is not ashamed to call them brothers. The word of the Lord.
If we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Pharisees approached Jesus and asked him, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing Jesus. Jesus said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must ever separate." Now in the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about all of this. He said to them, Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery. People were bringing children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these." Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it. Then Jesus embraced them and blessed them, placing his hands upon them. The Gospel of the Lord. The two become one. These words are from our gospel this evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Indeed, that's really the theme of not only our readings, but everything that Jesus seeks in our world, seeks for all of God's children, that we are one. That we are unified, or as our little saying today, together. Because that's the idea of love. It brings things together. It doesn't drive things apart or separate or divorce or abort or whatever term we use to separate ourselves from each other. No, indeed. We look at what Jesus is saying today through his eyes, the commandments, the great ones, loving God and loving one another. And as we do that, we experience togetherness. Well, it's not always the way people look at things. And indeed, in Jesus' day, the Pharisees, well, they were, it says, testing Jesus. They're always trying to trip Jesus up, make him say things that were breaking the law, and so they could have something to accuse him of and maybe hopefully get rid of him. Well, so they come to Jesus today, and they ask Jesus about divorce. Can a man do that? Well, Jesus right away turns it back onto them, knowing where they're coming from. He says, okay, tell me what the law is. What does Moses say about that? Moses was a big name. Big name, big lawgiver, gave the laws of God, supposedly. Well, they said, well, Moses allowed a husband to write a bill of divorce and in front of everyone, dismiss her. Well, actually, when Moses said that, he was already advancing from the understanding of people that, you know, get rid of a person for anything, for any reason, just abandon them. And in Moses, well, Moses took that one step more. No, you can't abandon anybody. You have to write up a bill of divorce. You have to say why, and in front of everyone. You can't just treat this person like a throwaway that you can get rid of at any time you want. There's no respect in that. Where is the awareness of who this person is? We are all sons and daughters of God. Or as our reading today says, you know, our first reading, how Eve was created. You know, she's taken from the very same flesh as man. The same flesh that God created. Well, that doesn't make her any less because she's second. No, it's the same flesh we're talking about here. The same creation of God within, together, in this thing called man. You know, from the very start, That's why Jesus said, well, Moses, he allowed you to do this because you wouldn't go any further than this. You wanted a divorce. So he just took you one step more, but I'm going to take you all the way. I'm telling you, and back up from Moses, back up to the start of everything. And I'm telling you, from the start of everything, God meant us to be together. One. He made them male and female, and the two become one. Well, of course, the key word here is become. You know, it's a process. Understanding the other person. You know, if God wanted us to all be the same, he created us all the same. If he wanted everything to be perfect, everything worked out just exactly, you know, perfect, well, we just sit back and not have to do anything about anything. Well, yeah, he could have done it that way. But that doesn't help us to understand that God's oneness is within each of us, that God's oneness is challenged and built up day by day by all the circumstances that come our way, by all the challenges that may come about. We say it makes life interesting. It's certainly not boring. But we got to remember the purpose of all of this is to bring us together where we belong, where we started, and where we will end up one of these days in eternity, beyond that, wherever. God will bring us all back together with him. But in the meantime, it's for us to understand how God is doing that in each and every event of our lives. And so it is today that Jesus, yes, he speaks about divorce and he speaks about adultery. He uses almost together. Well, that's the whole idea. Adultery is divorcing myself from seeing the good in you, trying to build the best. You know, we don't change into something different just because, you know, we entered the relationship of marriage. No, each person is still the same person. And each person hopefully seeks, as we all do, to be appreciated and loved and valued. Well, that takes a little time to see all that. And maybe the things that are preventing me from seeing that, well, okay, the two of us, different as we are going to be working out. You know, I can remember, of course, I thank my parents for this at the time, but at night when we were all in bed, we got all of us, seven of us in bed, well, it would be, often we'd hear in the next room or so, my parents just arguing about this and that and almost yelling at each other, but not quite, but pretty darn close, you know, about this and that, and this wasn't right and that wasn't right, and that, what are we going to do about this, what are we going to do about that? And then a little bit later, when all that would stop, they would go to bed, but before they did, they would kneel down and pray together. And I guess they were seeking that togetherness with the Lord that would keep them together, that they wouldn't begin any process of letting these differences pry us apart. No, they're just challenges. They're just things I've got to be about doing if I'm really going to see all the good that is within the person that I married. It's a day-by-day thing, and as the world changes around us, I'm going to have more challenges. We can't just say I ever know that person perfectly. I don't, because I haven't seen them and how they work and this and that, whatever situation, but I know we're going to stay together, and we're going to work on this to build something wonderful. And that's why Jesus today speaks not only about, you know, divorce and adultery and all that, you know, really the kissing cousin of divorce. The kissing cousin is really abortion when you think about it. Because in either way, we're cutting ourselves off from someone that needs to be valued and loved and cared for. We just cut ourselves off from them. And that's really what we're talking about here. And that's why Jesus speaks today about children. You know, children, they're looking for love and care and value. Where are they going to learn that? Well, the parents, hopefully, as they are becoming one, so also God has set it up. I mean, he could have done it with test tubes. He could have done it with just a spirit he creates, all of a sudden, boom, here it is, just out of nowhere. He didn't do it that way. No, it comes within a process of people appreciating each other, growing together. And this child comes to create a bigger togetherness that we call a family. Hopefully, as that is understood and worked on and appreciated, well, maybe there might be some hope for our world. Because that's God's idea here, that as we do these in little bitty chunks, you might say, trying to do our best, well, maybe we can bite off a little bit more and see all of the world as together to be loved and appreciated and valued. The two becoming one. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us now stand as together we profess our beliefs. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Again, we bring our needs to our Father in heaven.
For people throughout the world, may they recognize and treat each person with dignity and respect, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the homeless, and all who are in need, may they receive the material and spiritual assistance they need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those facing an unexpected pregnancy, may the peace of Christ fill their hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all elected officials, may they respect the dignity of each person throughout their service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peacemakers, may they unite hearts together in love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, may they draw strength from the Sacred Heart of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us, that together in his love, we may spread the good news of Jesus in all that we think, do, and say. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Don Gillen, Martha, and Mormon, and for our silent needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, help us always to appreciate the many ways that we can seek togetherness, one with you forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please join us in singing number 329, Song of the Body of Christ.
Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good, the good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, these holy sacrifices as we follow your command to love our neighbor. And through these sacred mysteries of your love, which we celebrate with our service, graciously complete your work within each of us. For we ask this through our Lord Jesus, who lives one God forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that always and everywhere we give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, for you have laid the foundations of our world, arranging the changing of times and seasons, for you formed each of us in your own image. Now you set us over your world in all its wonder, that we may rule in your name over all you have made, forever praising you as we seek to serve one another with all that you have given us. And so with all the angels we praise you, joining even the saints as we sing. Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, for Jesus has come in your name. Jesus is the Word that has come to bring our world salvation, a hand that you can extend to sinners, a way by which your peace is offered to us all. When we ourselves had turned away from you, you brought us all back to you, O Lord, so that together with you, we might love each other. And now, celebrating this reconciliation Christ has come to bring us, we ask that you sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become for us the body, the blood of Jesus Christ. For one about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, Jesus took bread into his hands. He gave you thanks. He said a blessing, breaking the bread, giving it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, Jesus took the chalice of blessing in his hands. He then confessed your unending mercy for all of us. Then he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Celebrating once again this memorial of the death and resurrection of Jesus, we offer you, Father, in what you have given us, a sacrifice of perfect reconciliation for our world. Holy Father, we humbly ask that you accept us also, together with Jesus, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his Spirit. For it is a Spirit that has come into our world to take away everything that may separate us from each other. May make your church this sign of unity, an instrument of peace among all people, and may keep us in communion with Francis our Pope, Charles our Bishop, and all of your people. For just as you have gathered us now at this table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her loving spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, especially Saint Maurice, along with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who die in your friendship. Bring us all to share this unending banquet of unity in a new heaven, a new earth, where the fullness of your peace ever shines as we will be together in the love of Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory, all honor is yours forever and ever. Together with the Father who created us, let us pray to him now as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from every distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming again of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of all in your church. Graciously grant us your peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always." Always seeking a oneness with each other, perhaps a sign of peace for one another. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of our world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us in singing 587, Christ Be Our Light.
At this time, sun catchers with this year's logo will be passed out to each household. We encourage you to place them somewhere in your home, reminding you that as family and parish, we are better together in God's love. One per household, so you might just gesture somehow so they know who to give them to. Thank you. If you're not from the parish, if you're visiting us, you're more than welcome to take one. And at the end of your benches, you will find a prayer, St. Joseph, Defender of Life. If you will pass those down, we will pray this together now in honor of Respect Life Sunday. And let us pray. Dearest Saint Joseph, at the word of an angel, you lovingly took Mary into your home. As God's humble servant, you guided the Holy Family on the road to Bethlehem. Welcome Jesus as your own son in the shelter of a manger, and fled far from your homeland for the safety of both mother and child. We praise you that as your faithful protector, you never hesitated to sacrifice for those entrusted to you. May your example inspire us also to welcome, cherish, and safeguard God's most precious gift of life. Help us to faithfully commit ourselves to the service and defense of human life, especially where it is vulnerable or threatened. Obtain for us the grace to do the will of God in all things. Amen. You're welcome to take these home for your home use.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by this holy sacrament that we have received, so that we may be transformed into the Jesus that we have consumed. For we ask this through our Lord Jesus, who lives one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing 583, They'll Know We Are Christians.
We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray that our unity may one day be restored. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand, we will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand, and together we'll spread the news that God is in our land. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.